Hello friends, in first two parts of hybridization we have seen sp3 hybridization. Today we will see what is sp2 hybridization. So what is the meaning of sp2 hybridization? Yes, mixing and recasting of 1s and 2p atomic orbitals, isn't it? 1s and 2p atomic orbitals, px, py. So hybridization is what? sp2. Examples: ethylene and a ch2 double bond ch2, boron trichloride, etc. So today we'll see in detail how there is the formation of ethylene, boron trichloride. Now ethylene, what is structure of ethylene? Structure of ethylene is here CH2 double bond CH2. Tell me total number of sigma bonds in ethylene. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Any 5 sigma bonds. And how many pi bonds? It is 1. Take first olefinic carbon. This is olefinic carbon. This is also olefinic carbon. To first olefinic carbon, total number of sigma bonds 1, 2, 3 and 1 pi. Remember, when 4 sigma bonds attached to carbon, hybridization is sp3. It is like this. Here 4 sigma bonds, single bond and always sigma bond. So here it is sigma, sigma, sigma and sigma. And a hybridization of this carbon is sp3. When 3 sigma and 1 pi, it is sigma, sigma and pi. So remember, 3 sigma and 1 pi bond, hybridization is sp2. Now take this carbon. Total number of sigma bonds to this carbon 1, 2, 3 and 1 pi, and 3 sigma 1 pi, and a hybridization of this carbon is sp2. Exactly same in case of this carbon. Total number of sigma bonds 1, 2, 3 and pi, so hybridization of this carbon is also sp2. And how many atomic orbitals are required to explain hybridization of this carbon? Only 3 atomic orbitals are required. That is why this is an example of limited hybridization. And ethylene is an example of limited hybridization. Now tell me, what is limited hybridization? Yes. So when mixing and recasting of what? 1s, 2p. When only required number of atomic orbitals are mixed, availability is more. But only required number of atomic orbitals are mixed, and that type of hybridization is said to be limited hybridization. Actually, how many atomic orbitals are available in carbon? In the excited state of carbon, yes, 4 atomic orbitals are available. But out of 4 atomic orbitals, only 3 atomic orbitals are required, 1s and 2p. That is why this is an example of what? Limited hybridization. Now we'll see step by step. So what is step 1? Ground state electronic configuration of carbon. Because here central atom is carbon, we have to focus on this carbon only. Olefinic carbon atoms. How many olefinic carbon atoms? 2. So what is step 1? Ground state electronic configuration of carbon. And a carbon at ground state. Here is step 1. Carbon at ground state. What is electronic configuration at its ground state? Outer shell electronic configuration only. Helium is the core element. 2s2, 2p2. n here it is 2px, 2py and 2pz. Now tell me total number of unpaired electrons, 2. And valence bond theory says that number of unpaired electrons equal to its valency. And on the basis of valence bond theory, carbon is divalent. But actually, what is valency of carbon? Valency of carbon is 4. So to explain tetravalency of carbon, hybridization is required. There is a need of hybridization. So what is step 2? Excited state electronic configuration. Step 2. And a carbon at excited state. Carbon at excited state. So what happens in excitation? Shifting of one electron from 2s to what? Empty 2p. Condition for excitation, empty atomic orbital is required. Here it is one empty atomic orbital. So shifting of one electron from 2s to what? 2p. Yani excited state electronic configuration of carbon is this one. And here 2s. Now 2px1. 2py1 and 2pz1, 2px, 2py and 2pz. Now tell me how many atomic orbitals are available? 4 atomic orbitals are available. 1, 2, 3, 4. Comparable energy because part of what? Second shell. And all these atomic orbitals are part of same atom, that is carbon only. With comparable energy, this is condition for mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals. So here, energy of 2s, 2px, 2py, 2pz comparable. And how many atomic orbitals are available? 4 atomic orbitals are available, but we want only 3 atomic orbitals because this is an example of sp2 hybridization. This is an example of what? sp2 hybridization and mixing and recasting of 1s and 2p atomic orbitals. How many are available? 4 atomic orbitals are available, but we want only 3. That is why this is an example of what? Limited hybridization. And when only required number of atomic orbitals are the part of hybridization, that is known as what? Limited hybridization. Step number 3. Carbon at hybridized state. Carbon at hybridized state. So here mixing and recasting of only 3 atomic orbitals. It is like this. Here it is 1, 2 and 3. So this is known as hybridization. Mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals. Here 1s and how many p atomic orbitals? We have taken only 2. This is s, px, py. So type of hybridization is sp2. And after mixing and recasting, an redistribution. Now each atomic orbital is said to be what? Hybridized orbital. So total number of atomic orbitals 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So total number of hybridized orbitals 1, 2, 3. And this one is sp2, this is also sp2, this is also sp2. And one atomic orbital remains in unhybridized state. This is a 2pz. So this is unhybridized. This is unhybridized atomic orbital. Now tell me what is the role of unhybridized atomic orbital. Remember, hybridized orbital gives sigma bond. Always. And a formation of sigma bond from hybridized orbital. And a formation of pi bond from unhybridized orbital. Because when there is a formation of pi bond, for pi bond sidewise or lateral overlapping is required, isn't it? When there is a formation of sigma bond, co-axial overlapping, direct overlapping is required for that, isn't it? So sidewise overlapping, lateral overlapping and a formation of pi bond. So for pi bond, p atomic orbital should be perpendicular and no shrinking is required. No shrinking is allowed about p atomic orbital because sidewise, that is lateral overlapping is there. And in that case formation of pi bond. When there is a direct overlapping, coaxial overlapping, formation of what? Sigma bond. So pictorial representation of this. Once again, ground state electronic configuration is the step one. Since only two unpaired electrons are present in the ground state of carbon, on the basis of valence bond theory, carbon is divalent, but actually carbon is tetravalent. So to explain tetravalency of carbon, excited state electronic configuration is required. So after excitation of one electron from 2s to 2p, now tell me total number of unpaired electrons, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, now valence is tetravalent, now valence is 4. Now how many atomic orbitals are available for mixing and recasting and for hybridization? 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. But we want only 3 atomic orbitals, that is 1s and 2p atomic orbitals, because this is an example of what sp2 hybridization. So only required number of atomic orbitals are the part of hybridization. That is why this hybridization is said to be what? Limited hybridization. Only required number, and 1s and how many p out? 2p out of 3. Actually 3p atomic orbitals are there, but we want only 2. That is why limited hybridization. So here 1, 2, 3 sp2 hybridization, and one atomic orbital remains in its unhybridized state, because formation of pi bond from this atomic orbital, because total number of pi bonds in ethylene, 1. So how many unhybridized atomic orbitals are required? 1. Because hybridized orbital gives what? Sigma bond. And unhybridized atomic orbital gives what? Pi bond. Now pictorial representation of this, diagrammatic representation of this. You are mixing and recasting of 1s and only 2p atomic orbitals. Then how to show? With the help of orbital diagram, pictorial representation of this. Here it is s. Shape of s atomic orbital is spherical, that we have already seen. You are well familiar with this. Here one electron. Spherical shape, non-directional, like this. How many electrons are there? One electron, this is 2s. Now 2px, this is x axis, this is y axis, this is z axis. In 2px, there is one electron. Here it is one electron. In 2py also, there is one electron. In 2pz also there is one electron. So here it is one electron in each atomic orbital. Suppose this is 2px, this is 2py, this is 2pz, we can take, and one electron in each. Now mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals, and due to interaction, what happens? Spherical s atomic orbital converts into half dumbbell. Converts into half dumbbell. It is like this. This is the first sp2. This is the first sp2. Now remember, this 2pz remains as it is. There is no shrinking of opposite lobe of 2pz, because it remains in unhybridized state. It remains as it is. No shrinking of opposite lobe. It is like this. Here one electron. This is unhybridized 2pz. Unhybridized 2pz. In case of 2px and 2py, shrinking of opposite lobe. So here, it is second sp2. And it is third sp2. So total number of sp2, 3. 1, 2 and 3. See here, there are opposite lobes, shrinking of opposite lobe. Here, exactly. And a shrinking of opposite lobe due to interaction, due to pulling, isn't it? So total number of sp2 hybridized orbital, 1, 2, 3. Total number of atomic orbitals participate in hybridization, 1, 2 and 3. Because this is unhybridized as it is, without any change. And this is a diagram of what? Hybridized carbon. This is the diagram of what? Hybridized carbon. You know what is structure of ethylene?
Yes. Structure of ethylene is like this. CH2 double bond CH2. And both are olefinic carbon atoms. Both are symmetrical. Exactly same. We have seen about one carbon. Exactly same for second carbon, ground state, excited state, mixing and recasting. Exactly same diagram. Like this. And this is hybridized carbon. Now how there is the formation of ethylene? How there is the formation of ethylene? Here it is the first hybridized carbon. And how there is overlapping? How there is the formation of bonds? Take this carbon as it is. This is the first carbon. This is unhybridized atomic orbital. Now sp2, this first sp2 of first carbon, it is the first sp2 of first carbon. And first sp2 of second carbon, it is like this. Here it is like this. Hey, there is a coaxial overlapping, head-to-head overlapping. And when there is a head-to-head or coaxial overlapping, formation of sigma bond. This is the first sigma bond. Here it is formation of first sigma bond. Now take unhybridized atomic orbital of first carbon and unhybridized atomic orbital of second carbon. And this is 2pz1 of first carbon and 2pz1 of second carbon. Both are unhybridized. But the position of these two atomic orbitals are exactly, these two are perpendicular. These two are exactly perpendicular to what? Internuclear axis. This is the internuclear axis, perpendicular. And when p atomic orbitals are perpendicular, formation of pi bond and sidewise overlapping. And here formation of pi bond. This type of overlapping is known as what? Sidewise overlapping. Now, take first carbon, we used only one sp2, now second sp2 of first carbon and first hydrogen, it is like this. And again there is a coaxial overlapping. And remember, when there is a s atomic orbital, always it gives sigma bond because it is a non-directional. So here it is sigma bond. Now third sp2. And second hydrogen. Here formation of another sigma bond. Head to head overlapping, direct overlapping. This is about first carbon atom. Now second carbon atom, we used again only one sp2. Now second sp2 and first hydrogen. Because on second carbon also two hydrogen atoms are there. CH2 double bond CH2. On first carbon two hydrogen atoms. Here these two are spherical and hydrogen atoms. Similarly, on second carbon also there are two hydrogen atoms. We got what is structure? CH2 double bond CH2. So here second sp2 and first hydrogen. Here it is coaxial overlapping formation of another sigma bond. Exactly in case of third sp2 and second hydrogen, it is like this. And a formation of again sigma bond. Now tell me total number of sigma bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 5 sigma. And how many pi? It is 1 pi. Only one lateral overlapping. So here 1 pi. Sigma and this is pi. So this is the structural representation and a pictorial representation of ethylene. Total number of sigma bonds are 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is hybridized carbon. This is also hybridized carbon. Any sp2, this sp2 of first hybridized carbon and sp2 of second hybridized carbon, formation of what? Sigma bond, because there is a coaxial overlapping, head to head overlapping and a formation of sigma bond. These two are in a 2pz of first carbon and 2pz of second carbon. There is a lateral overlapping because these two are perpendicular. And when p atomic orbitals are perpendicular, formation of what? Pi bond and a sidewise overlapping. Here formation of pi bond. And in between two olefinic carbon atoms, one is sigma And here it is sigma and here it is pi. Exactly same in case of remaining sp2. Here sp2, this is also sp2. Now sp2 of this and hydrogen, first hydrogen. Again there is a co-axial overlapping and a formation of sigma bond. Third sp2 of first carbon and second hydrogen. Again there is a co-axial overlapping and a formation of another sigma bond. Similarly in case of this carbon, sp2 of carbon and first hydrogen, there is a co-axial overlapping and a formation of sigma bond. Exactly same here, sp2 of first carbon and formation of what? And s atomic orbital of hydrogen, co-axial overlapping and a formation of another sigma bond. So here different types of overlappings are there. Yes, same. Yes, exactly same. And sp2, s, sp2, s, sp2, s, sp2, s. And four times sp2, s overlapping. And four times sp2, s overlapping. And one time p of first and p of second, this overlapping is said to be p pi overlapping. And a p pi bonding, isn't it? So total number of sigma bonds are 5, total number of pi bonds are 1. Now what is geometry of this ethylene molecule? If we draw stick model of this, stick model of this, it is like this. Compare this structure with this. Here carbon carbon double bond, one sigma and one pi. This is sigma, this is sigma, this is also sigma, this is also sigma. If we join all these points, it is like this. It is like a planar trigonal. Exactly same here. So what is geometry? Geometry is planar trigonal. And remember, when geometry is a planar trigonal and this bond angle, and this bond angle is 120 degree. This bond angle is what? 120 degree. Bond angle is 120 degree. And this hybridization is also known as a trigonal hybridization, planar trigonal hybridization, because geometry is a planar trigonal, bond angle is 120 degree. And this is an example of what? Limited hybridization. Because required number of atomic orbitals are the part of hybridization, isn't it? So this is an example of sp2 hybridization. Remaining, that is about BF3, BCl3 in next lecture. Thank you.